In this video, I'd like to look at a couple of concepts related to Newton's second law and acceleration and tension. The force due to gravity on this 1 kilogram mass hanging around a pulley is going to provide the force to accelerate this cart along up here. And so we're going to have the wheel accelerating in this direction, and we're going to set the problem up based on that. Let's start out by looking at the free body diagram for the mass on the left. We're going to define the acceleration based on a positive x, positive y here. So if the wheel is rotating counterclockwise here, then we're going to have a positive acceleration here. And so our AX in this case is going to be a positive A. Free body diagram shows that we've got a normal force acting upwards, an acceleration due to gravity acting downward, and a tension in the string acting to the right. Based on that, let's look at the sum of the forces in the Y component. We've got a positive Fn and a negative Fg, and we let that equal to our acceleration, or in this case, because there's an equilibrium in the y direction, it's equal to zero. And that tells us that the normal force is equal to the gravitational force acting on it, as we'd expect for an object that's sitting on a flat surface. In the x direction, we've then got a positive tension, and that is what's going to cause our acceleration. So we've defined it as a positive acceleration in that direction, and I'm going to call this one a big M and this one a little m. Even though they're the same mass here, a smaller mass can accelerate or pull a larger mass along a pulley in that way. And I'm just easier to keep track of them. On the right-hand side, then, I can define my own coordinate system again. I can define what coordinate system I want. Over here, then, I'm going to call this my positive Y. And to keep it consistent that when this accelerates in the clockwise, it's a clockwise direction, I'm going to have a positive acceleration this direction. And so that means we have an AY being a positive A. It's going to have the same magnitude as it is for the cart to the left, and I'm going to keep them positive, so I'm defining my coordinate system so that both A's are positive this way. My free body diagram over here then is going to have that tension in the upward direction, that's my T1, and I'm going to have a downward force of gravity. I'm going to call this for the hanging 1 kilogram mass. The force of gravity over here is going to be mg, so it's a 1 kilogram mass. Acceleration is downward, but I've defined that as positive, so it's a positive 9.8 meters per second squared. In other words, it's going to be 9.8 newtons. For this mass, I only have y components. I don't have any x components. And so I've got that tension, T1, in the upward direction, and so it's negative the way I've defined the axes here, plus mg in the downward direction. It's positive. And all of that gives me my acceleration for that mass. And I can rewrite that then as T1 is then equal to mg minus ma. And so you'll notice here that the tension is less than the force of gravity. It's reduced by this acceleration. So it's letting gravity win a bit, and it's going to be less than the force of gravity. It's going to be less than that 9.8 newtons. If it was stationary or no acceleration, it would be equal to mg. I'm now going to look at the sum of the forces, the net forces for this mass on the right. I don't have any x components. I only have the y components. I've got the tension acting upward, which is negative in the way that I've defined it here. Plus I've got the force due to gravity of that hanging mass. And all of that is the net force giving me the acceleration of that mass. I can rewrite that this way so that it's telling me the tension is going to be less than the force of gravity on that 1 kilogram mass. So it's letting the gravity win a little bit, and it's actually going to be reduced as it accelerates because it's accelerating downwards towards that force of gravity. If there was no acceleration, if it was stationary or in equilibrium, then it would be just equal to the force of gravity or the due to that mass. And if I was accelerating upward, like we saw in the elevator problem, then that would be a positive, and the tension would be larger than the force of gravity. So now I can take these two equations, and I can combine them for that tension. And so combining them, I get big M times A is equal to the force of gravity of the hanging mass minus the acceleration, mass times acceleration. And I'm going to pull the acceleration to one side and the force to the other side. And you should notice here then that the force of gravity on that 1 kilogram mass is what's causing the acceleration of the entire inertia, both of those masses together. Now I'm going to solve for the acceleration. So I take the force that is causing that acceleration divided by the total inertia, and plugging in values, I've got on the bottom, I've got 2 1-kilogram masses total. That just ends up canceling out for simple math and units. And I get a total of 4.9 meters per second squared. In other words, half the acceleration due to gravity, because I've got the force of gravity on one of them needing to accelerate twice the inertia. So that should make sense. It's half of the acceleration due to gravity. Let's have a look at the tension then. What will the tension be? I can plug that back in now to solve for the tension. It's a 1 kilogram mass up here times that acceleration of 4.9 meters per second squared. And that gives me a total of 4.9 newtons. So the force of gravity on the right is almost 10 newtons, and the tension in the cable is about 5 newtons. It's half the amount. Lastly then, I want to show one other thing. What if I now have my 5 kilogram mass? So I have a hanging 5 instead of a hanging 1. This is now 5 kilograms times my 9.8 meters per second squared. And so I'm going to have a 49 newtons here, or almost 50 newtons. So I'm going to put this, I'm doing this part here now where I've got a 5 kilogram mass. The acceleration in that case means I've got a 5 kilogram mass that's giving me my force, my accelerating force because of the force of gravity, pulling that mass down, but it now has to move 2 5-kilogram masses in terms of inertia. I again get some canceling, and I again have 4.9 meters per second squared. In other words, for 5 times the mass, I need 5 times the force to achieve the same acceleration. And I've done that. I've put in 5 kilograms here instead of just a 1 kilogram, because I needed it to move a 5 kilogram mass in the second case. So I put both of them at 5 and I end up with the same acceleration. However, what about the tension? What will my tension be now? Now I've got 5 kilograms that I'm trying to accelerate, 4.9 meters per second squared, that same acceleration. But instead, I now have 5 times the tension at 24.5 newtons. It's still half of the value that I have over here. So I saw that 10 newtons became 5 newtons, and now I see almost 50 newtons becomes 25 newtons. So my tension is going to be 5 times higher. The force of gravity is 5 times higher on that 5 kilogram mass, but I still get the same acceleration. So a quick little recap. Some of the things that you should pay attention to. Notice how I defined my positive axes so that they were consistently going in one direction. That made it easy to keep track of my positives, but it meant I had to be aware of my signage over here. So the tension was upward, that was actually a negative, but I had a positive acceleration due to gravity as it headed downwards. You'll notice that this force of this hanging mass is what was giving me all of the acceleration for the total inertia, both of the masses put together. And because they were equal in mass here, the two of them are the same, I ended up with something that was half the acceleration due to gravity for my total acceleration. And that gave me then a tension that was half of the force due to gravity that was pulling it down as well. So that's because of the symmetry of the problem and the way I built it up. And last thing was then to accelerate five times the mass, so where I now put both of those masses, where I put five times the mass on the cart, I then needed five times the mass pulling it in order to get that same acceleration. And that led me five times the mass, five times the force, five times the tension.